Hi everyone, this is Shariq and welcome back to another lesson with Globetrot with Arabic. This is really probably the most spontaneous lesson that I have ever recorded. Excuse my appearance. Sorry a shakli or sorry a manzari. Manzar means appearance or shakl means the way you look basically, and also shakl means shape. So sorry a manzari لأنه عم ركب الخزانة because I am assembling the wardrobe لأنه because عم ركب ركب means assemble عم ركب means I am assembling عم ركب الخزانة. As you can see, I am putting these I forgot what you call these. The musmar. I will write it in Arabic. I will remember it now. So musmar. This is musmar. هيدا musmar. Okay. وهيدا شاكوش. هيدا مسمار وهيدا شاكوش. عم فوت المسمار means I am putting the مسمار in. Okay. So I'm recording this lesson because I promised you that I'm gonna record one lesson every day, and today I am moving my furniture, I'm moving to a new place, so I have to do a lot of work, but I didn't want to break my promise, so I thought we can record this together. So hella حطيت الشيكو حطيت المسمار جوا. So, or I can say دقيت. دقيت means literally I touched, but also it also means like when you press something in. دقيت, okay? So, دقيت المسمار, again. دقيت المسمار. So, بالأول, initially, بالأول, initially, فكيت الخزانة. فكيت means I disassembled فكيت فكيت الخزانة. This is a wardrobe by the way. فكيت الخزانة وهلا ركبت الخزانة. I assembled the cupboard and I'm putting the last pieces. عم بحط المسامير. So مسمار is in the singular form and the مسامير is in the plural form. So حطيت المسامير. Or there is more that I'm gonna put. I'm gonna say رحت المسامير. So حطيت is in the past and رحت is in the future form. حطيت المسامير in the past and رحت المسامير in the future. بس خلص, when I finish. بس خلص. خلص means I finish. بس means whenever or when. So when I finish بس خلص. There's another cupboard that I'm gonna dismantle and move to the room. So في خزانة تانية, okay? في خزانة تانية لازم فكها. There is another wardrobe which I have to disassemble. في there is خزانة wardrobe تانية another لازم I must فكها. So فك means to undo something or to disassemble something. But when I said fika is the her, I have to disassemble her. In English you would say I have to disassemble it. Basically in Arabic I would say there is this wardrobe which I have to disassemble it. في خزانة تانية لازم فكها. So I will continue doing this now, but I will record the other parts of my work as well, okay? So I will stop the video now. I will continue in a bit. See you in a bit. By the way, since I'm doing this, I want to show you some of the tools that we use, okay? And maybe you can learn these names, the names of these tools in Arabic. So as I said, the hammer is shekush, shekush, the hammer. This one is the screwdriver is mfak braghi. As I said, mfak is something that you undo something with or disassemble something. So It has the same verb, the same root of the verb. So the verb of mfek is yfik. So for example, ana bfik, I undo, or ana fakkayt, I undid. For even for my hair, if I want to put my hair down, I say ana fakkayt sha'ri, I put my hair down, or ana bhab fik sha'ri, for example, I like to put my hair down, fik. Okay, so ana fakkayt in the past, ana bfik in the present, and the noun of it is mfak, the thing you undo something with, mfak, okay? So the opposite of fakkayt is rabatet, I tied, rabatet, rabatet, or burbut in the present form, I tie as well, burbut, rabatet. So this one is called mfak braghe. Why? Because braghe in the singular form is a screw. Braghe is in the plural form. So brghe, one, brghe in the plural form, brghe. Mfak brghe, the tool which basically undoes or disassembles something. So that's why we call it mfak brghe. Mfak brghe. And by the way, now I remembered that these are the little ones are called nails. So this one is mismar. Mismar is the one that I'm putting in. Mismar, the nails. But the screws are brghe and brghe. So mismar in the singular form, mismar. In the plural form, it's msemir. So mismar, wahad, one nail. Msemir, msemir in the plural. Brghe, the screw, brghe in the singular, baraghe in the plural, baraghe, brghe, baraghe. And this one is mfak braghe, mfak braghe. This one is shekush, shekush. And this is another mfak braghe. You see this one that has like a cross? I think we call this mfak braghe salib. Salib literally means cross in Arabic, salib. I think, if I'm not mistaken, this one is called mfak braghe salib because the shape of it is like a cross. And this is another one, mfak braghe. I'm not sure how we call this, the flat one. Okay, but if you say mfak braghe, that's, I think, more than enough. This one, I think in English it's called players. I didn't know, I just discovered players. So in Arabic we call this bensa. Bensa. So bensa, mfak braghe, shekush, another mfak braghe. The screw is braghe and baraghe, and the nail is mismar and msemir. And finally, I have the measuring tape. In Arabic, we just call it, in Lebanese Arabic, we just say meter. When in meter? Meter means meter. Yeah, meter. So for example, when in meter, بدي أخذ قياس الخزانة, I want to measure the wardrobe. We say, I want to take the measurement. بدي أخذ, I want to take, بدي أخذ قياس الخزانة. Again. بدي, I want, اخد is I take, yes is the measurement, yes, the size basically, yes, it also means size, measurement, بدي اخد, yes, لخزانة, I want to take the size of the cupboard. I will stop now and I will record what happens during the day, and I will also put it together in the same video or maybe in another video. I'll see you in a bit. I will continue putting the nails in. So رح كمل, رح كمل means I will continue. رح كمل دق المسامير. دق means just to put them in. Yeah, okay, see you in a bit. Hi again guys, I finished with the first cupboard, so I assembled it. ركبت, ركبت أول خزانة, I assembled the first cupboard. وهلأ بدي بلش فيك تاني خزانة. And now I'm gonna start disassembling. I hope this word exists. Disassembling the second cupboard. وهلأ رح بلش أو بدي بلش. I will start or I want to start. وهلأ رح بلش فيك تاني خزانة. Disassemble. فيك رح بلش فيك تاني خزانة. So رح أبرم الخزانة كبيرة كتير. رح أبرم. I will turn. رح أبرمها. I will turn it. رح أبرم الخزانة. I will turn the cupboard. It's empty. فاضية. So منا تقيلة. It's not heavy. منا تقيلة. تقيلة is the feminine form of heavy. تقيل is the masculine form of heavy. So منا تقيلة. So أول شيء, first of all, أول شيء لازم شيل. I have to remove. لازم شيل هيدول المسامير الصغار. These small nails. So أول شيء لازم شيل هيدول المسامير. So if you notice, I'm pronouncing المسامير as المسامير because I'm putting a liaison. So رح شيل هيدول المسامير الصغار. These small nails. Sorry, I was out of the screen. So the reason why I want to do this is because I want this room to be completely, completely empty, because I want it to be a place where I can just record lessons and just put mirrors and make it like a little dance studio. So أنا رح فضي هيدي الأوضة. I will empty this room. رح فضي. فضي is to empty. رح فضي is I will empty. رح فضي هيدي الأوضة كلياً. I want to empty this room completely. رح فضي هيدي الأوضة كلياً تيصير عندي استوديو للرقص. تيصير عندي استوديو للرقص. استوديو for dance. واستوديو للتسجيل. And a studio to record. أنا كتير مبسوطة. أنا كتير كتير مبسوطة. I am very very happy. لأنه بقدر أعمل هالشي. Because I can do this. لأنه بقدر I can أعمل do هالشي. هيدا الشي abbreviated as هالشي. This thing. أنا كتير مبسوطة لأنه بقدر أعمل هالشي. Because prices in London are very 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 expensive. So I came out of the center a little bit. So I can afford at least just a room. Really having a room in London is something most of the times unaffordable and difficult, especially if you're trying to create something new and starting a business, so you will be broke most of the times. So I want to say I left the center and I rented a little studio outside of the center. So أنا تركت السنتر. We will say centre. We can say وسط المدينة, the middle of the center of the town, but we usually say centre. تركت السنتر. أو تركت وسط المدينة. Some people will say وسط المدينة. وانتقلت. انتقلت means I move. انتقلت. وانتقلت لبرا لندن. For برا outside. لبرا لندن. وانتقلت لبرا لندن. لأقدر. So that I can. لأقدر يكون عندي أوضة. So that I can have a room. على القليلة. At least. على القليلة. أوضة. كرمال سجل دروس to record lessons, وكرمال يكون عندي مراية, a mirror, مراية, كرمال أرقص ساعة اللي بدي, so I can dance whenever I want. Okay, I think that's enough for today. I will show you the end result probably tomorrow. This is gonna take me at least 2 days. هيدا الشي بياخد, this thing takes, هيدا الشي بياخد تقريبا يومين. So I will show you the stuff as I'm going along. Okay, that's it for today. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye. Yalla, bye. شوفكم بكره.